Hello, my name is Travis Legletter. I'm with the Purdue Weed Science Program, Weed Science Program Specialist, and today we're going to be talking about taking leaf tissue samples for herbicide resistance testing. So again, this year the Purdue Weed Science team, along with the Pest and Diagnostics Lab and Indiana Soybean Association, will be offering resistance screening for Palmer amaranth, water hemp, and giant ragweed. So the big thing with these leaf tissue samples is that we make sure that we're getting the freshest material that we can possibly get, and that means the newest material as well as keeping it fresh from the field to when it gets to the laboratory. The quality of that sample plays a big part in the quality of the results that we can return to you. So the first thing is to make sure that we're sampling from the top 6 inches of the plant or the newest growth. This is the area where our lab is best able to extract the genetic material they need to do the testing. Now, we also want this from 5 separate plants. So within that field in which you suspect resistance, we want you to sample 5 different plants, so 6 inches from the top of the 5 different plants, and put those plants into separate plastic baggies. Again, we want those in plastic baggies that keeps the moisture within that plant sample. The big thing with that though is if you're taking those samples and you're not going to be shipping them within the same day, or you're going to be out in the field for a while, let's make sure we put those into a cooler. It's an ice pack, and that will keep those samples fresh. Avoid sticking them on the dash of your truck or inside of a hot vehicle. The samples really start to break down fairly quickly when we put them into those hot situations, and that leads to where we cannot get the genetic material out of that plant that we need. We'd like you to ship the samples within 1 to 2 days of collecting them, place them all into one baggie, again within the 5 individual baggies, and ship them overnight. We'd like to have those shipped during the week so that we can receive them. If you're shipping it on a Friday overnight, that's going to sit at the loading dock at Purdue over the weekend, so that's not going to be good. The other thing is make sure that we're filling out that form as completely as possible. That information is helpful to us as the Purdue Weed Science team in helping keep track of where we're facing resistance issues in the state, and also checking the boxes for the type of screening that you're wanting and putting it in the appropriate place. Again, this will be leaf tissue samples rather than seed samples. We'll have another video covering the seed samples. For any questions regarding the delivery of the samples or the processing of the samples, you can contact the Purdue Plant and Pest Diagnostics Lab. For any questions regarding the sampling or testing, you can contact Julie Young. Their information is also on the submission form.